Oh my gosh. And in our new addition, we're putting a window facing. And I said, do we really want a window facing that?
Being a witness?
Yes.
I saw that.
No,
I
thought,
yeah, why is
it? And then we lose a black dress.
And then the youngster in the front seat.
I know.
So he pulled up just on one of the side roads. And, I love our Amish community, they don't drive really well.
They drive very fast.
And if you look at their cars, they're all like young underneath.
Yes.
And I thought, he's not going to stop, And I even went up with the gas, but I thought, I don't know if I'll have packets now.
Yes.
And then he pulled into the road and then backed up.
And he backed up? That's how far up he was.
And then coming into town, he was right on my
head. Yes, he was.
That's what they do,
What is your problem?
And I'm like, where are you going in such a hurry? Probably the kid was late for school.
That's exactly what I thought.
But leave earlier.
I bet that kid's late for school. Because it was a little tight in the front seat. And I thought,
oh, I was like, goodness gracious, that truck is going way too fast.
Isn't that funny? As you drive, I am pretty confident of my skills, but I am not confident of your own.
Right.
So I'm constantly looking at other people. Do they see that sign? Do they see that car? Do they see this?
And I think because we live in the country, I pay more attention to the side roads.
I do too.
Than a lot of people do, because we know people don't stop us. And like you said, our Amish community is great, but they are the ones that don't stop.
Yeah.
But it's not only them.
No.
Because there's this white car, and it's not an Amish person, and it's coming west and east every morning at a certain time, and it blows that stop sign at 40. I'm like, do you have a death wish?
Right.
Because you know the semis that come?
Yes. I was going to say, that doesn't go on.
They can't stop on a dime.
Right.
Oh my gosh, it scares me.
It does. When Jen was with me in the car somewhere, right before she got her license. And I said, Jenna, you can be as good a driver as there is. You can get an A+ in driver's ed. But I said, you have to watch out for everybody else because people are stupid.
Yes. Yeah. Well, look at whoever that person in that truck yesterday on Route 30 got killed.
Yes.
It was a high-speed chase.
And Rock Falls.
It started in Sterling and came over to Rock Falls. And this Mercedes, and it hit a truck head-on and killed an innocent person. I mean, they have life-threatening injuries also, but they killed an innocent person who was just driving down the road.
Right. At 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
At 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
What did you hear about the former mayor in
Morrison?
Morrison! And he killed his wife?
Yes. You know what? I bet he had a stroke.
That's what
they were going to church, I bet.
And Orange Street's
Orange Street.
Yeah, would have been going, maybe.
Yes.
And so that amazes me. How could it have been such a forceful accident to kill them? It's in town.
Yes. Yes.
Then Johnson, same thing, was ahead of you.
Yep. Rod and I are both like, something happened. 79, 78 years old. They weren't driving fast.
Right.
But the tree they hit, the person in the car said they heard an acceleration. It's just like the Stickle Boy that died.
Yeah.
Died before, and his foot hit the accelerator, and he went right through and ran into a house. he did it. Thank God nobody in the house got hurt.
Yeah.
But it was he had died. He had, and I bet that's what happened to this
gentleman. A stroke or something. But they airlifted him, but even if he survives, how could you live with that, knowing that your wife passed away and you were driving?
If he does survive, you're right. He won't last long.
No, I
couldn't live with
that.
He finds out his wife died.
Yeah.
That is sad.
This is what I keep telling Bill. I don't think my father-in-law, who's 92, should be driving. And I keep telling him, I said, Bill, how would you feel if you caused an accident? I know that it's time. He keeps telling me.
What was my mother? I knew it was time because she had a license all through her strokes and everything. But there was a point at which I took the car because she would go to Sullivan's in Mendota, the grocery store there.
Yes.
And she would back out and she would back into somebody, and both people were backing at the same time. And she said, she'd kind of laugh about it. She's like, we didn't see each other. But it kept happening.
Yeah.
And that was the, was when.
We knew it was time. It's hard.
It is very hard.
And it's hard to take a license away from a man.
And
yes.
My mother was upset about that because it was her
independence.
Well,
it's her independence. You got it.
Yep.
Well, and Mary Ann Batten, I asked her. She said she didn't drive anymore.
No,
and I said, does it go to the station? And she said, yes.
She lost.
Yeah.
She said, yeah, I remember I saw Becky about shortly after that happened, and she said, my mom just got lost one day, and she called me, and she said, okay, Becky, I should have been driving.
Yeah.
And I'm like, good for her.
Exactly.
Good for her that she admitted it.
Yeah.
It is hard. It's hard.
Yeah, but yes, one day too.
Yeah. Well, we all made it. It's 40 days.
Thank the Lord, right?
Yeah,
exactly.
A breath in and out. And another breath in and out. Taking our arms up overhead. Leaning to the right side. Letting that bottom hand fall away. And stretching out. And bringing both hands back to heart center. A breath in. And out. Taking our arms up. Overhead and lean to the left side, letting that bottom hand fall away and stretching out and returning both hands back to heart center. We'll take the left hand over to the right knee, right hand travels around behind, overlooking the right shoulder. And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso and seeing if you might be able to look behind you. Returning back to center. And we'll take that right hand to our left knee. Wow, the fan or whatever goes off, this is kind of loud. Left hand travels around behind us, overlooking the left shoulder. And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso and seeing if you might be able to look behind you on the other side. And coming back around to center. A breath in and out. Taking our legs wide, stretching out. Right hand to the right ankle, stretching the left arm over top. Bringing that left hand down to our right toes. Right hand to our right toes. And exhaling down. Nose to the right knee. Inhaling up, left hand, left ankle, and stretching the right over top. Bringing that right hand to our left toes, left hand to our left toes, and exhaling down, nose to the left knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, left fingers, right toes, and again, exhaling down. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, and exhaling down. And inhaling up, stretching wide, again, left fingers, right toes, and exhaling down. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, and exhaling down. Inhaling up, stretching our arms wide, bringing those elbows in, right forearm over the left. Interlacing our fingers, and we're going to turn our torso off to the right. Coming back to center. And turning our torso to the left. Returning back to center. Exhaling, we'll think about dropping our elbows down onto the mat. Maybe resting our forearms on the mat. Perhaps touching our forehead. Two more fingertips. Keeping in that forward fold position, we're just going to stretch our arms out front and exhale our forehead a little closer to the mat. And inhaling up, stretching our arms wide, bringing our elbows in, left forearm over the right, connecting our fingers. Again, we're turning our torso off to the right. Coming back to center. And turning my torso to the left. Coming back to center. And again, exhaling down, dropping those elbows down to the mat. Maybe resting our forearms on the mat. Perhaps touching our forehead to our fingertips. And then we're going to keep that forward fold, but stretch our arms out front and exhaling our forehead a little closer to the mat. And then inhaling back up, we'll bring both legs together for our forward fold. Inhaling up, bending my right knee, putting that right ankle on my left thigh and stretching forward for my left toes. Taking both legs long, forward fold. Inhaling up, bending the left knee, putting that left ankle on top of the right thigh and reaching forward. For our right toes. And taking both legs long again. Our forward fold. Inhaling up, and we'll take this into a reverse table. So feet down, hands behind our backside. Picking up our backside and boosting it up a little bit more towards the ceiling and holding. And then resting our backside down. Breath in and out. Again, our reverse table, pushing down with our feet, down with our hands, boosting our tummies up towards the ceiling. Resting our backsides down. We'll do one last reverse table, pushing down with our feet, down with our hands, bringing our tummies up towards the ceiling. And coming all the way down, lengthening our legs, inhaling our arms up overhead, exhaling down, inhaling up. Exhaling down, inhaling up, and exhaling down. And coming forward into our table position, hands and knees, starting in our cow with our head up and relaxing our back. Here's cat, inhaling, tugging my head. Arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. And exhaling around into our cow. Our cat again, inhaling, tugging my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up. And holding. And And exhaling back around. Into cow. One more cat. Inhaling. Tugging my head. Arching my back. Pulling my tummy up. And exhaling back around. Into our cow. Here's our pigeon. We'll put that right ankle in front of that left knee. Pushing that left leg back. Drawing up from the torso. And taking both arms up overhead. We'll bring that left hand behind the left thigh. Taking both arms back up overhead. Bringing those hands to heart center. Turning my torso off to the right. Coming back to center. And turning my torso to the left. Coming back to center. And we'll drop both hands down by that right knee. Reaching back with that left hand for our left toes. Maybe taking the right arm up. Bringing both hands down by that right knee. Exhaling down onto our forearms. And exhaling one more time. Dropping my forehead onto the mat. As I stretch those arms out front. Coming back into our table position. I'll bring that left ankle in front of the right knee, pushing the right leg back, drawing up from the torso, taking both arms up overhead. Bringing that right hand behind the right thigh. Taking both arms up overhead. Bringing those hands to heart center. Turning my torso to the right. Coming back to center. Turning my torso to the left. Coming back to center. I'm dropping both hands down by that left knee. Reaching back with the right hand for the right toes, and taking that left arm up. And bringing both hands down by the left knee. Exhaling down onto my forearms. And exhaling one more time, dropping my forehead onto the mat. Stretching those arms out long in front of me. Into that table position. A breath in and out. We'll cross the right ankle to the top of the left thigh. And then we're going to tuck those left toes and pick ourselves up into down dog. Keeping that right ankle on top of the left thigh. Dropping that left knee back down to the mat. Again, that right ankle stays on top of the left thigh. We're tucking those left toes, and again, picking ourselves up into down dog. Keeping the right ankle on the left thigh. Dropping that left knee down to the mat. And we're going to do one more this side. So that's that right ankle on top of the left thigh, tucking those left toes and picking ourselves up into down dog. And we'll come all the way down into our regular table. Up, breath in
left. We'll turn to the right side. Looking back at that right foot. Coming back to center, turning to the left side. Looking back at that left foot. Returning to center. Now I'm going to put that left ankle on top of the right thigh. I'm going to tuck my right toes and pick myself up into down dog. Dropping that right knee down to the mat. Left ankle is still on top of that right thigh. Tucking my right toes, picking myself up, down dog. Dropping that right knee down to the mat. And we'll do one last one. So we're tucking those right toes, picking ourselves back up into down dog. And then we're coming down all the way out back into our table. Again, we're turning to the right side, looking back at that right foot. Returning to center, turning to the left side, looking back at that left foot. Coming back to center, we'll stretch that right arm all the way out in front and take that left leg out behind us. Bending my left knee, drawing that right elbow back, connecting, left knee, stretching out, bending that left knee, drawing that right elbow back, connecting, left knee, and stretching out. We'll bend that left knee, taking that right hand around, seeing if we can hang on to those left toes. And coming back into our table. A breath in and out. We'll stretch that left arm out in front and see if that right leg comes out behind us. Bending my right knee. Drawing that left elbow back. Connecting. Right knee. Stretching out. Bending that right knee. Drawing my left elbow back. Connecting. And stretching out. This time as we bend the right knee, we'll take that left hand around and see if we can hang on to those right toes. And coming back into our table. Our nice breath in and out. Tucking our toes, we'll pick our backsides up into down dog. And we'll start by walking dog. Right knee forward and back. Left knee forward and back, just like we're walking. Settling back into our down dog. We'll take the right hand over to the left ankle. Coming back, down dog. Left hand over to the right ankle. Coming back, down dog. And then we'll bring that right foot forward in between both hands in front. And when you're ready, inhaling up for your warrior one. Connecting my palms together, extending forward over the right thigh. Bringing that right hand back by my hip. Pushing the left arm forward. Bringing both arms forward. And back up. Warrior one. down on either side of the right foot. Scooting my right foot back into down dog. And then I'll bring that left foot forward in between both hands in front. And when you're ready, inhaling up for warrior one. Connecting my palms together, extending forward over the left thigh, bringing that left hand back by my hip, pushing the right arm forward, bringing both arms forward, and back up, warrior one. Take both hands down on either side of the left foot, scooting that left foot back again into our down dog. And we'll take that into our three-legged dog, so it's going to be on the left foot, and we'll take that right leg out behind us. Keeping that right leg out behind us, can you drop down onto your forearms? And then pushing back up into your three-legged dog. Dropping down onto your forearms. Pushing up into your three-legged dog. Dropping down onto your forearms. And pushing up, three-legged dog. Bending that right knee, turning my hip outward, dropping that foot over my hip. Need it to be a little harder, walking your hands back. Let's see if you can put them around that left ankle. And coming back into our down dog. We'll take that left leg out behind us. And we're going to drop down onto our forearms, pushing back up into our three-legged dog, dropping down onto our forearms, pushing up, three-legged dog. Do one more. So here we go. We're going to drop down onto our forearms and push up, three-legged dog. Bending that left knee, turning my hip outward, dropping that foot over my hip. And if you need it to be harder, walking your hands back. And see if you can put them around that right ankle. And returning, down dog. Walking my feet forward, right behind my hands, slowly rolling upward, reaching on up, and coming back into our mountain. A breath in. And out. We'll take the right hand down the outside of the right thigh, stretching the left over top. Coming back into our mount. Left hand down the outside of the left thigh, stretching the right over. over top. And coming back into our mount. We'll take this into our triangle. Right foot is forward, left is behind. Arms are out. Right hand, right ankle, and the left arm is up. Maybe taking that right arm out to the side. Bring both hands around the right ankle, looking up for our gazing pose. And making our way back up. Stretching our arms out, left fingers, right ankle, and the right arm is up. Maybe taking the left arm and pointing it out to the right side. Bringing both hands around the right ankle, looking up for our gazing pose. And making our way back up. Settling into our mountain. A breath in and out. Triangle other side, left foot is forward, right is behind. Stretching our arms out, left hand, left ankle, and the right arm is up. Maybe taking the left arm out to the right side. Perhaps bringing both hands back around that left ankle, looking up for our gazing pose. And making my way back up. Stretching my arms out. Right hand, left ankle, and the left arm is up. Maybe taking the right arm and pointing it out to the left side. Bringing both hands around the left ankle, looking up for our gazing pose. And making our way back up, settling into our mount. A breath in and out. Here's our sun salutation, arms overhead. Coming forward into our forward fold. Hands behind our calves, relaxing our head, relaxing our neck. Putting our hands on the mat in front of our toes, bringing those hands up to our knees, down to the mat, up to our knees, down to the mat. And once more, up to our knees. And back down to the mat. Leaving the right foot forward, taking the left behind into our lunge. Right palm is down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing the right hand down, we'll inhale up for our side angle, right forearm on top of the right thigh, and taking that left arm overhead. Only thing we'll change is the position of our arms, left forearm on top of the right thigh, and taking the right arm overhead. And then taking that into our reverse warrior. Right hands is a look at the sun. Bringing both hands together, heart center. Connecting my thumbs between my eyebrows, looking up. Bringing those hands back to heart center. And our twist, left elbow, right knee, turning to the side. Both hands down by that right foot, splitting that right foot back into our down dog. tucking my chin, bringing that left knee forward and holding. Putting the left foot down, tucking my chin, bringing that right knee forward and holding. Putting the right foot down, and then I'm walking my feet back into my plank position. Here's our hip dip right, right hip towards the mat. Coming back into our plank, hip dip left, left hip towards the mat. Coming back into my plank, and I'll walk both feet forward, bend my knees, and come up into my chair position. Putting my hands on the mat, walking my feet back into plank. Walking my feet forward, coming into chair. Placing my hands down, walking my feet back into plank. One more chair, walking our feet forward, bending our knees, taking my arms out front. And then last but not least, walking back into one more plank. And coming all the way down. Your choice, either resting on your forearms for sphinx, or palms down, and pushing back for cobra. When you're ready, tucking your toes, down dog. Tucking my chin, bringing that left knee forward and holding. Putting the left foot down, tucking my chin, bringing that right knee forward and holding. Putting the right foot down, and then taking the left foot forward, the right is behind, into my lunge. Left palm is down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing the right hand down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down. We'll come up in our side angle, left forearm on top of the left thigh. Taking the right arm overhead. Only thing we'll change is position of our arms, right forearm on the left thigh. We're taking that left arm up. Overhead. And taking that to our reverse warrior. Left hand sits a little to the sun. Bringing both hands together, heart center. Connecting the thumbs between my eyebrows, looking up. Bringing those hands to heart center. And our twist. Right elbow, left knee, turning to the side. And we'll put both hands down by that left foot. Getting ready, bringing that right foot forward into our forward fold. Slowly rolling upward, reaching on up. Settling into that mountain position. A breath in and out. Let's do our warrior two. Right foot is forward, left is behind. Bending the right knee. Arms are out, overlooking the right fingertips. Taking the right hand up. Coming back, warrior two. Take the right hand tits up. Coming back, warrior two. Bring that lower left forearm forward, connect it to the outside of the right lower leg, and take that right arm up towards the ceiling. And unwinding. Coming back. Warrior two. And stepping into our mountain. A breath in. And out. Warrior two, other side, left foot is forward, right is behind. We're bending the left knee, arms are out, overlooking those left fingertips. Taking the left hand up. Coming back, warrior two. Taking that left hand all the way down, the right is up. Coming back. Warrior two. And we'll take that into our little bit of a twist. Right forearm to the outside of that left thigh. And taking the left arm up towards the ceiling. And coming back. Warrior two. And finally stepping back into our mount. Breath in and out. We'll come forward into our table, hands and knees. Taking that breath in and out. We'll think about putting our head down on the mat, stretching those arms long behind us, maybe interlacing my fingers, lengthening my arms, rolling my shoulders back. And coming back into my table. I'll put my weight on that right palm and that right knee as I turn to the side, taking that left arm up overhead. And if you choose, picking up that left leg. We'll take that top arm and top leg out to the side, connecting fingers and toes. Coming back to that position on our side. Taking the left arm and left leg out to the side again, connecting fingers and toes. Coming back to that position on our side. Once more, we're going to take that left arm and that left leg out to the side. Coming back to that position on our side. And we're going to come back into our side plank, straightening that bottom knee. Coming up, taking the left arm up. And as we come down, we'll come back into our table. A breath in and out. We'll put our weight on the left palm, the left knee. We turn to the side, taking that right arm up and maybe picking up the right leg. We'll take the right arm and the right leg out to the side, connecting fingers and toes. Coming back to that position on your side. Taking the top arm and top leg out to the side. Connecting fingers and toes. Coming back to that position on your side. And we'll do it once more. So we're going to take that top arm and then top leg out to the side. Connecting fingers and toes. Turning back to that position on our side. And if you so choose, coming into our side plank, straightening that bottom knee, and coming up. As we come down, we're headed over onto our backs. Feet down, knees up, arms wide. A breath in and out. We'll cross the right leg over the left. And then we're going to take both knees off to the left side. If you want to do shrimp pose, taking that top leg, extending it nice and long with the right hand, reaching around for the toes or the ankle on the bottom, and maybe taking that left arm up towards the ceiling. Now, can you bring those left fingers to the toes of that top leg and hold? And then we're going to come all the way out into our neutral. Feet down, knees up, our breath in, and out. We'll cross that left leg over the right, and we're taking both knees off to the right side. Getting ready for our shrimp pose, we'll take that top leg, extending long. With the left hand, we're reaching around for the toes or the ankle on the bottom. And maybe that right arm comes up towards the ceiling. Can you reach with those right fingers for the toes of the outstretched leg? And then coming back around into our neutral. Feet down, knees up. A breath in and out. We'll take that right leg all the way up towards the ceiling. And we're going to roll that right ankle. First one way, and then the other. Pulling my toes towards me, pushing them away, towards me, and away. And starting that circle with my right leg. Making that circle go around the other way. Taking that right leg all the way up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, lowering that right heel halfway between the ceiling and the floor. And holding. As you exhale the next time, dropping that right heel almost to the mat. Not quite there. Letting it hover. And then we'll take that right leg all the way up towards the ceiling, and with both hands, we're reaching for those right toes. And then releasing out, feet down, knees up, and we'll take that left leg up towards the ceiling. Rolling that left ankle, first one way, and then the other. Pulling my toes towards me. Pushing them away, towards me, and away, and starting that circle with my left leg. Making that circle go around the other way. Taking that left leg all the way up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, lowering that left heel halfway between the ceiling and the floor, and holding. As you exhale the next time, dropping that left heel almost to the mat, not quite there, letting it hover. And then taking that left leg all the way up, and with both hands, we're reaching for those left toes. And hands releasing out, feet down, knees up. We'll take both legs up towards the ceiling. And we're going to make a motion like we're bicycling. And you can either keep the bicycling motion if you want to make it harder. You're going to interlace your fingers, put them behind your head, and it'll be opposite elbow to opposite knee as those knees come forward. Relaxing back, coming into our neutral. And then we'll roll over onto our right side. Stretch that right arm out nice and long. Put that right ear on that right arm. Bottom leg is long, top knee is bent. We'll bring that top knee up to our chest. Extend that leg out to the wall. Bring the whole leg back around. Bending that top knee. Drawing it up to our chest. Extending that leg out to the wall. And bringing the whole leg back around. Once more, bending that top knee. Drawing it up to our chest, extending that leg out to the wall, and bringing the whole leg back around. We'll take that top leg all the way up, and with the left hand, we're reaching for the left toes. And we're rolling on to our tummies for our crocodile. Our fingers get to look at each other, and we'll put one ear down. Turning our head, putting the other ear down. And then finally making our way onto the left side. So we're going to put that left arm out, that left ear on the left arm. Bottom leg is long, top knee is bent. We'll bring that top knee up to our chest. Extend that leg out to the wall. Bring the whole leg back around, bending that top knee, drawing it up to our chest, extending that leg out to the wall, and bringing the whole leg back around. Once more, bending that top knee, drawing it up to our chest, extending that leg out to the wall, and bringing the whole leg back around. With the right hand, we're going to take that right leg all the way up and reach for those right toes. And then from here, we're headed into our child's pose. On our backs, sponge pose. And we'll begin with those deep breaths in and out. Inhaling all the way in and pushing the air all the way out. See if we can extend our inhalation for about 5 seconds and then push the air out for about 5 seconds.
to notice that place, that pause between your inhalation and your exhalation. Slowly bringing your awareness to your forehead, smoothing out your forehead. Relaxing your eyebrows. Relaxing that place between your eyebrows. Drawing the relaxation down through your cheeks and into your jaw. Maybe opening your mouth just a little bit as you invite your jaw to relax. Drawing the relaxation down through your neck. And as you exhale, dropping your shoulders, releasing them. Thinking about deepening that space between the bottom of your ears and the tops of your shoulders. Drawing the relaxation down through your arms, into your wrists, softening your hands, releasing your fingers. Allowing your thoughts to just come and go. Not dwelling on any one thing. Bringing that relaxation down through your chest, into your tummy. Relaxing your hips. Softening your thighs, releasing your knees, lower legs, ankles, and your feet, and taking a moment to continue to drift and melt, continuing to slow everything down. And moving on today's journey, you find yourself beside a pond. And as you look next to the pond, you notice a big old maple tree. Noticing the shapes of the leaves. Noticing what season it is. And as you continue to concentrate on that maple tree, you notice the breeze filters through the leaves on the top of the tree. The leaves drifts down, making its way towards the water. Watching that leaf gently coast down. And now that leaf is resting on the surface of the pond.
With the next gust of breeze, you notice some ripples forming on the top of the pond. And that leaf bounces a little bit. And then as the gust leaves, the pond water becomes still again, and the leaf settles down. Again, there's that gust of breeze, rippling the surface of the pond water, causing that leaf to bounce a little bit with the ripples. And as the breeze passes, again the water becomes still, and that leaf rests on the surface of the water. Taking a moment here in this beautiful place to see what's meant for us to see on our journey today. Coming back to our breath, noticing its peaceful, easy rhythm. Taking a moment to give thanks for whatever comes to mind today. Also taking a moment to think about our intentions, all those good things we'd like to do, gathering those positive affirmations in our mind. And when we have those intentions gathered together, either in our mind's eye, we can raise our arms up over our head and send all those good thoughts outward. Taking a deep breath in, exhaling out. Reconnecting with our bodies. Noticing the rise and fall of our chest as we inhale and as we exhale. Checking in with our fingers, wiggling our fingers, seeing how they feel. Checking in with our toes, wiggling our toes, noticing how they feel. Allowing our senses to bring us back to the room around us, any sounds in the room, the temperature of the room. Taking a deep breath in, exhaling out. And when you're ready to come back from your journey, only when you're ready to come back, gently sitting up and taking your time.
Happy Wednesday.